Why is Adam Sandler considered a bad actor? While Hollywood's top actors strain themselves in brutal tough films for awards, Adam Sandler is on the other side of the world in Hawaii on a vacation, disguised as a shitty romantic comedy or dumb action movie. No, I am not kidding. During an interview on Jimmy Kimmel Live, when asked if he just made movies for vacations, he replied, "Yes, I have done that since 51st Dates, it was written in another place. I said, imagine if we did it in Hawaii, how great that movie would be. And they said, yeah, that's a very artistic idea. I've been doing that ever since." One, and I have a feeling he's not kidding, at all. He's unlocked the secrets to Hollywood and manages to get paid while on vacation with all his friends, deliver a few funny lines and call it a day. Rinse and repeat. Sandler is considered a bad actor because he doesn't push himself to become critically acclaimed. Comedy movies are notorious for being especially hard to gather strong performances, and Adam certainly falls into that demographic. But at the end of the day, Adam Sandler is much more of a household name than many higher-regarded actors, and perhaps there is a bit of genius to that. When Adam decides vacation time is over, however, he easily proves to everyone that he isn't a talentless hack, and behind the goof there lies a serious body of talent. He did so in Punch Drunk Love, which consistently places in both critics' and audiences' favorite lists and is the crown jewel out of his romantic comedies. And of course, Uncut Gems, a performance I thought to be one of the best in 2019, and I know I certainly am not alone in this thought. He is completely committed and plays this tortured character to the point where many people describe the film as the most intense of the year. For a complex and fatally flawed character, Adam captures each tick, each subtle body movement to a masterful degree. His performance resembles one of a highly experienced actor, and despite his lesser movies, that's what he is. What a slap in the face that must have been for his haters to see him transform so drastically. For every 100 flops he makes, there will be one where he can reiterate his position as an influential actor, and does so with shocking ease. When Adam is given a script, he feels obliged to accept he will deliver a show-stopping performance. When he is given a free trip to Hawaii to film a movie, his performance will be less than stellar. That's where his reputation comes from. But I don't blame Adam Sandler. Because most of his career is about churning out films that place economic reliability above quality. He does this consciously and very successfully, which has made him a lot of money, but made few films with genuine artistic merit. I remember reading an article, and this was probably back around the time Jack and Jill came out, where someone, only partly facetiously, asked why studios were still giving Adam Sandler money to make movies. He'd been coming out with multiple films every year, had been since the late 90s, and most of them were complete trash. And the author of the article announced that it's no mystery, his films are consistent moneymakers. None of them are blockbusters, they're generally forgettable, but people watch them. This author said that studios could count on his films like clockwork. His production company, Happy Madison Productions, would crank them out. They'd cost about $80 million apiece to create and distribute, and they'd pull in about $150 million at the end of the day. No world changers, but almost all of them make as much money as they expected. In an industry that takes a multi-million dollar risk every time they greenlight a project, having a predictable and reliable profit center is very appealing. It's the classic issue in every form of media and entertainment, and none more than films. Do you take a chance and try to create art, knowing you'll lose a ton of money if it fails to connect with an audience? Or do you find a formula that caters to the lowest common denominator and consistently makes cash? Adam Sandler has mastered the latter formula with his brand of lowbrow, eminently silly, man-child comedy. I mean, he mastered it 25 years ago, and it hasn't stopped working, so he has no reason to stop doing it. Because that's the bulk of his work, that's what he's known for. And Mr. Sandler seems entirely self-aware about this. He once opened a convention speech by saying, "My name is Adam Sandler. I'm not particularly talented. I'm not particularly good-looking. And yet I'm a multi-millionaire." I've heard a number of accounts suggesting that he's surprisingly down-to-earth, and acts like a guy who considers himself lucky to have made it big. A successful acting career that's lasted a quarter century and where he's largely in control over his own projects? That's not a common thing in the film industry. Having found a pattern that works, it makes sense that he'd keep doing it.